Mother Goose. How are you, dear? I'd like to tell you a lovely old fairy tale called The Sleeping Beauty. Once upon a time, there lived a king and a queen who wanted a child more than anything else in the world. Finally, a daughter was born, and they named her Briar Rose. Now, to celebrate the birth of the princess, the king and queen invited everyone in the kingdom to a party, including 7 kind fairies.
Welcome, welcome everyone. Enjoy yourselves. Eat, drink, dance. Then come meet our beautiful daughter.
After much eating and dancing, it was time to give gifts to the baby princess, Briar Rose. The 7 fairies came forward, one at a time, and gave very special gifts.
Briar Rose will be beautiful in every way. She will sing like an angel.
Briar Rose will always be honest.
The first 6 fairies gave the gifts of beauty, music, honesty, bravery, grace, and a loving heart. The 7th and last fairy, Belinda, was about to give her gift when the room filled with whirling light and smoke. There suddenly appeared another fairy. Her name was Ferusa.
Well, are you all having a good time? Why didn't you invite me to your party? Or didn't you want me to be here?
Oh, no, no, please, that's not true.
We didn't know there were 8 fairies.
Nonsense!
Ferusa wasn't pleased at having been forgotten. In fact, she was quite angry.
Well, now, I think it's my turn to give a gift to your little Briar Rose.
She approached the sleeping baby and gave her gift. On her 16th birthday, Briar Rose would prick her finger on the spindle of a spinning wheel and die.
Oh, no! You can't mean that!
That will teach you to leave me out of your party plans!
Then, with a whirl of black smoke, Ferusa disappeared. Everyone was quite upset, and they didn't know what to do. When Belinda stepped forward.
Please, I haven't given my gift. Maybe I can help.
She could not take away Farooza's evil gift of death entirely, but she could change it to sleep. A sleep that would fall upon the entire castle until the princess could be awakened by a kiss from a courageous prince.
There now, that won't be so bad.
Immediately, the king ordered that all spinning wheels in the kingdom be destroyed. 16 years passed. Briar Rose was everything the fairies had wished her to be. And everyone at the castle loved her, for she was always kind. Now, on the day of her 16th birthday, everyone was busy getting things ready for the party that night.
Coming, Jane! Coming, Jane!
Oh, where are the lights going on?
It's for you, Princess.
We're having a party for you.
When Briar Rose learned that the party was for her, she raced to the king and queen to thank them.
Oh, Father, Mother, thank you. What a wonderful surprise.
Surprise? Well, it isn't anymore, I'm afraid. Happy birthday, Princess.
Oh, Father.
Well, you are 16 today. And look at you. You're everything we ever hoped for. And more. Sweet girl of 16, you have brightened the sunlight. You made every day bright with your lovely smile. Sweet girl of 16, how did that tiny baby become a young lady in such a short while? You've grown up so quickly, in only a moment. You're now above. Sweet girl of 16, with the strength deep inside you, and examples to guide you.
Could have been happier that day. As the king and queen made party plans, Briar Rose wandered about the castle. In the courtyard, she found an unusual tower that she had never seen before.
How very strange! I've never noticed this before.
She climbed the old winding staircase within the tower, up, up, up to the top. At the top of the stairs, was an old wooden door with a rusty key in the keyhole. She turned the key, lifted the latch, and went inside the room.
Come in, my child. I won't hurt you.
There sat an old woman next to an old machine with a large wheel at one end.
Close the door and come a little closer, dear. Look, I'm making magic. I can turn wool into thread with this machine. See how the pretty wheel goes round and round?
Briar Rose approached the old woman and reached out to touch the machine. It was a spinning wheel, and as she touched it, she pricked her finger on the spindle and... Briar Rose fell into a deep sleep. In a great puff of smoke, the old woman magically turned into the fairy, Farouza.
That will teach you not to forget me!
As Farouza vanished, a sleep gently fell over the castle, as in Belinda's wish. The guards stopped guarding, the cooks stopped cooking, and the children stopped playing. Everyone fell fast asleep, even the king and queen.
Oh, look at that beautiful cake. It has big rose on it.
To prevent anyone from rescuing the princess, Farouza magically placed a thick wall of giant rose bushes with very sharp thorns all around the castle, making it impossible to get inside. And no one ever did. The castle remained totally quiet behind its wall of thorns for a very long time. News of the sleeping princess spread throughout the country. Many young princes tried to cut through the thorny wall to get to her, but the thorns were sharp and the branches were thick. Everyone who tried failed.
Oh, it's so old! Oh, ooh, ow! Oh, ow! Oh, all these thorns! Ow! Oh, oh,
I do! Oh, there's
no way to get through!
Oh, these are sharp!
Then, one day, a young prince came from a distant land to rescue the princess. Cold and tired, he spied a campfire in the forest just outside the castle.
Oh, it's cold, and that fire looks so warm.
There, he met a strange little man who had been keeping watch over the castle for many long years. His name was Grizzle.
You look like you could use a fire to warm your bones. Here, sit with me a while.
Thank you, sir. I could use a rest. I've been traveling for days.
The two shared the fire, and the prince asked Grizzle about the sleeping princess.
Yes, I know of her. Many have tried to set her free, but they've all failed. You'll fail too. You have to have a strong will, determination, and a lot of courage to get through those thorns. And I'm not so sure you have those qualities.
Oh, but I do.
Do not.
I do.
Do not.
The prince was certain he could rescue Briar Rose, but Grizzle would not believe him, and he kept shaking his head.
Go on home like the others.
No, I've dreamed of this princess, and I've come a long way. I'm not going to quit now. I just know I can save her.
And not!
I'll show you. Nothing will stand in my way.
With that, the prince mounted his horse and rode quickly to the castle. Grizzle had made him even more determined. He pulled out his sword and swung every branch that stood between him and the dream of his princess.
I cannot give up. I must save her. I must get through.
A dream will never happen unless you make it happen. Just dreaming dreams is not enough to make those dreams come true. To make your dreams all happen may take a lot of courage.
And you must not let anything discourage you.
For if a dream is worth the dreaming, then it's worth pursuing. What else should you be doing but making dreams come true? And you will find if you work real hard that anything can happen. And you can never let a challenge get the best of you. A dream will never happen
unless you make it happen.
You can't let all the dreams you dream just go floating on by. And when your dream has happened, it will seem to others watching that your dream has simply happened in the twinkling of an eye.
Were strong, but so was the prince. Swinging his sword and making every blow count, the prince swung his sword again and again. The thorns tore at his clothes, but he didn't give up. Until he hit a very large branch and...
the door!
He found the door to the castle. As he touched the door, it magically opened before him, and he stepped inside. All around him, the prince saw everyone sleeping. His heart guided him to the winding staircase in the tower, and to the old wooden door with a rusty key in the keyhole. He turned the key, lifted the latch, and opened the door. There, sleeping so beautifully, was Briar Rose.
She's even more beautiful than I dreamed.
The prince gently kissed her. Then, as Belinda the kind fairy had said, Briar Rose opened her eyes and smiled at the prince.
Oh, hello. Today's my birthday. Did you know?
I didn't know.
Instantly, everyone in the castle awoke. As if nothing had happened, the guards continued guarding, the cooks continued cooking, and the children continued playing. Briar Rose came down the stairs, arm in arm with the prince.
Happy birthday, Briar Rose!
Oh, it was a happy birthday indeed. The spell of the angry Firouzah had been broken. Briar Rose and the prince were married, and seven kind fairies came to the wedding. No one ever discovered that it was Grizzle's test of courage that helped the prince succeed, and that Grizzle was really Belinda all along.
And when your dream has happened,
It will seem to others watching that your dream has simply happened in the twinkling of an eye. And they all lived happily ever after.